rewind a little bit. Looking back, I mean, I'm looking at the Buckcherry, you know, history, and I'm saying, wow, 15 years together as a band, Grammy nomination, 6 records, you got a best of collection out now. Was it always your goal and Keith's goal? When I think of Buckcherry, I think of you and Keith Nelson being the nucleus, really, of the band, to be one of the great, authentic American rock and roll bands.
Yeah, that was the dream. I mean, we always wanted to be in one band and create a catalog of music and work real hard, you know, and the plan is working out. You know, we've had a few little blips here and there in the road, but...
As every great band does.
Yeah, you know, you just got to weather the storm and really stay focused on the beacon, which is, you know, all your goals and what you're, you know, we're always reassessing our goals, like, on a monthly basis, you know, so, you know, we're always trying to move towards something.
Confessions, your most recent record, such a great record. Your kind of take on almost the 7 Deadly Sins, sort of?
Yeah, you know, a lot of people have done it, but we want to do our take on it. It's something that Keith and I threw around for a lot of years, and originally we wanted it to be like just the 7 sins on an EP, you know, and then we're like, we got to do a whole LP, so I kind of created a story around it, and that's where, you know, songs like Water and Air, you know, we were going to do the 4 elements as well. So,
well, the songs have always really been the catalyst to drive the band. I mean, a great band can be a great band, great live band, but you really have to have songs. You guys have a lot of textured songs. It's party rock, it's in your face, but still you have the textures of some of those great ballads. I feel like there's a piece of you particularly in every song. Is that kind of, yeah?
Well, yeah, I mean, I write all the lyrics, so there's definitely a piece of me in every song. Yeah, you know, it's not all my life, but, you know, I like to attach some of my personal feelings and my personal experiences into the songs, but, you know, sometimes I'll take, you know, just bits and pieces of the culture that I've seen over the years and all the different places we travel and books that I've read and relationships that I've, you know, witnessed, you know, that have been around me a lot and stuff like that. You know, I'll write songs just about anything that kind of moves me.
And being now the rock veteran that you are, what do you think of the social media craze and how quickly, not even social media, but how the business is changing so much? Bands are a little more in control maybe than when you guys started. Is that something that you love, you embrace, you think is like a super cool thing for upcoming bands? I mean, because it changes so quickly. Even 3 years to now, 3 months from now, it's just ever changing.
Yeah, well, you know, like everything, there's pros and cons. Which one do you want to hear?
Give me the cons. I'm wondering, does social media freak you out a little bit when you're getting tweeted at all day? Or, you know, what is that like for you now? Because we're all sort of out there and everybody's watching our every move, every minute of every day.
I really didn't know how many insecure people we have on this planet, you know, because they feel the need to let everybody know everything they're doing at every part in the day, you know. So that's a little strange to me. It's really made everybody live in a small town. And I never liked that feeling of living in a small town, everybody knowing your business and all that. So that part of it, I think, really sucks. I think there's no more mystery. There's no more controlled market. So nobody's really ever shocked about anything because they can just sit in their house and explore the world. You know, that's a tough one to get around.
How about bands being able to take over a little more freedom in their career? You don't have to necessarily wait for the record label or for them to do this, or you can really have a little more basic artistic freedom, right?
Right, that's definitely the pros. The pros are you get to market your record and get to your fans on very cheaper than you used to, but you're also not making a return on your records at all. There's like last year, 2013, not one rock band sold a gold record, which is awful, you know.
It is awful.
It makes it really hard for people who want to do this for a living, you know, unless you have an established fan base. It's a real challenge. You got to be on the road, like, all the time.
Well, I was going to say, when you take it back to the live show, then that's really kind of the old school thing. It sort of brings it all back full circle when you guys jump on stage.
Absolutely. You know, it's all about the live show. I'm glad we built our reputation on that, you know, because now we're, you know, we're still in it.
Yeah, you're still in it. You're like one of rock's greatest frontmen. No pressure, of course. No pressure.
It's like a, that's a big statement.
Well, I heard a rumor, you guys, are you guys working on some new stuff? Maybe an EP or something, I heard?
Yeah, we got an EP. It's already done. It's in the can. We're waiting to get it mixed. It's going to be out in the spring. There's definitely a theme to this EP, and if you're a Buckcherry, if you're a Buckcherry fan, you're gonna, it's a must-have.
Awesome, awesome. And I wanted to just wrap with, you guys have done so much. Like I said, Grammy nod, 15 years together as a band, put out your best of collection, all songs that the fans love. What for you has been one of those watershed rock and roll moments where you're like, I look back on my career and I can't believe I did blank?
We were in Europe on our first record. And Lit Up was taking off on the radio here, and we had no idea what kind of momentum it was building. We had never played in Jersey, and we came home, and we had a show booked, and it was sold out. And we were like, how is this show sold out? We had no idea how the show was sold out. We didn't really understand the power of radio at that point in time. And we played that show, and it was a real turning point for us, you know, because that's when things just started taking off for us, you know. So it was a real memorable moment.
We're so happy to have you back in New Jersey. And Josh, it's a pleasure to sit down with you, especially on show day. I know it's really tough. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.